I am continuing the design of riveted joints from question bank. I am taking problem number 2 now. In the previous this thing we had done problem number 1. I am taking problem number 2. Two plates of 10 mm thickness, T is 10 mm, are to be joined by means of a single riveted double strap butt joint. The type of joint is double strap butt joint or double cover plate butt joint. Also, it can be told double strap butt joint. Determine the rivet diameter, rivet pitch, strap thickness, that is TC, it is called strap thickness. And efficiency of the joint, taking the working stresses in tension and shearing as 80 MPa, 80 megapascal and 60 megapascal respectively. So this is the problem. It's a double strap butt joint with single riveting. So now first again we have to find out the dia of rivet, that is again 6 root T, 6 into root of 10, that is root 10 under root 10 equals this much into 6, that will be 18.97. I am getting 18.97 mm, say 20 mm, take it as 20 mm, minimum you have to take 19, even if you take slightly bigger, no problem, a slightly higher value, there is no problem in that. D is equal to 6 root T. Then we have to find this we got. Then we have to find rivet pitch. To find rivet pitch, P minus D into T into rho T, that is tearing strength. This is done. Tearing strength is equal to shearing strength, that is N pi D square by 4 into tau into 1.875. That is because it is a double strap butt joint. Every rivet will pass through 3 plates, top cover plate, main plate and bottom cover plate. So it has to break at 2 places. So you have to have this 1.875 extra. Right. So P will be equal to N pi D square into tau into 1.875 divided by 4. T into rho T, that is these two will come here, plus D. So N is 1 here. It is single riveted. So 1 pi D square. I have taken D as 20. So 20 square into tau, that is 60, into 1.875 divided by 4. Into 10 into 80 plus 20. So take the calculator, pi into 1 is 1, you can leave, pi into 20 square into 60 into 1.875 divided by 4 divided by 10 divided by 80, that is 44 point something plus 20, that will give me 64.17. 64, you can take it as 64 mm, this is coming. Now P max will be equal to C into T plus 41.28 millimeter, that is from your design data handbook. Now the value of C depends upon N and type of joint. For double strap butt joint, single riveted, number of rivets per pitch length is 1, N is 1. So the value of C is 1.75. This you can get from a table in the design data handbook, value of constant C. For single number of rivets per pitch length, 1. This is N is equal to 1. The joint is double strap butt joint, for that the value is 1.75 into T is 10 plus 41.28. This gives us how much? 17.5 plus 41.28. That will give me 58.78 mm. So I cannot take pitch more than this. For this joint, the pitch cannot be more than that, more than 58.78, though I have got this value as the pitch by equating tearing strength to shearing strength. Now I will have to take, so adopt, because P max is less than the calculated value of P, adopt rivet pitch. P is equal to 58.7 mm. Take, this is done. Next, TC, cover plate thickness. This will come only in butt joint. Cover plate thickness will be, if it is double strap, for double strap, butt joint, TC will be 1.125 T, that is 1.125 into 10, that is 11.25 mm. This should be the thickness of the cover plate. If it is single strap, no, this is double strap, no, this is, it should be, sorry, it should be 0.625 T. This should be point, TC should be 0.625 T, that is 0.625 into 10, that is 6.25 mm. This should be the thickness of cover plate. Now, for finding efficiency again, what we have to do is find out PT. PT is P minus D into T into rho T. That is, P is, we have taken it as 58.7 minus D is 20 into T is 10 into 80. So 38.7 into 800, it is 30,960 Newton. PS, N pi d square by 4 into tau into 1.875. N is 1, pi into 20 square by 4 into tau is 60 into 1.875. So pi into 20 square into 60 into 1.875 divided by 4. That will give me 35,343 newton. So these are the strengths, tearing strength and shearing strength. You need not find out PC because crushing strength is not given. That means it is not likely to fail in crushing. So it is not given. Now the possible failure is due to this. This is lesser. 30,960 newton is lesser. So the first possibility of the failure of the joint is due to tearing of the plates along a row of rivets. So that is the first possibility. Now the efficiency will be equal to, efficiency of the joint will be least of, only two are here, one is PTR PS, PC is not there, divided by strength of solid plate, that is P into T into rho T. So PT 30,960 divided by P is 58.7, which T is 10 into 80. So 30,30960 divided by 58.7 divided by 10 divided by 80. That will give me 0.66 approximately, 0.66, or it is 66%. If you multiply it by 100, it will be 66%. I hope you have understood it. We will work out quickly one more problem. We will select one more problem from here. Next, question number 7. Problem number 7. A double riveted double cover strap butt joint. Double riveted, N is 2, double strap butt joint is made for 12 mm thick plates. 12 mm thick plates with 18 mm dia rivets. 18 mm dia rivets. Find the efficiency of the joint. Find the efficiency of the joint for a pitch of 80 mm. For a pitch of 80 mm. If permissible tensile stress is 115 MPa. Tau is permissible shear stress is 80 MPa. And permissible crushing stress is 160 MPa. Now here, he himself has given both dia of the rivet and pitch. Only what we have to find out is the efficiency of the joint. That's all that we have to find out. These two are already given here. So we have to find out. I'll have to find out for first tearing strength. Tearing strength will be P minus D, T into rho T. That is P is 80 minus D is 18. Into small t is thickness of the plate is 12 into rho t is 115 MPa or 115 newton per mm square. So that will be 80 minus 18, 62 into 12 into 115. That is 85,000 560 Newton. This is the tearing strength. Next, shearing strength. N pi d square by 4 into tau into 1.875, because it is a double strap butt joint. N is 2. Pi into d is 18 square divided by 4 into tau is 80 into 1.875. So 2 into pi into 18 square into 80 into 1.875 divided by 4. It gives me 340.7. You can take it as 341. Then crushing strength, N into D into T into rho C. So N is 2, D is 18, T is 12, into this is 160. So 2 into 18 into, into 12 into 160 equals 69,120 Newton. So I think this is the lowest. 69,120 is the lowest. So efficiency will be equal to lowest of the three, that is PC divided by strength of solid plate per pitch length, that is PTFT. So 69,120 divided by P is 80. 80 into T, 12 into 115. So that will be 69,120 divided by 80 divided by 12 divided by 115. 0.626, that is 62.6%. That is the efficiency of the joint. I hope you have understood. I have worked out three problems. I think this is the procedure to be followed. You can work out some more problems and practice.